Say something on that thing, Kenny.
I ain't chromed on me. You got 22 coming to you now.
All they're doing is just coming up here and hooking on to the fence and dragging you down there. That's the only thing.
Buddy, police, your wife know you're here? I can't tell who it is, Scott. Yeah. Yeah, that's fine. You ain't caught anything. Golly, you look nice when you... Throw that thing at me. Okay. I saw that one though.
Girls, but should be tomorrow. This is your fourth classic. What is it? The highest order of bass fishing. The fish. Yeah, but you use it for fishing. 23-4. It's 21-12. Tell me this, we want a little improvement. Without knowing any details, roughly how many fish did you catch today?
Caught 8 keepers today, right?
8 keepers?
Right, I found one little spot and we caught 5 out of it, and then I caught 3 more just scattered around.
You stay there. You stay long enough to catch 5 fish in one spot?
Well, there were so many of them there, where I'd throw, I'd catch one. I was trying to get out of there as fast as I could. It kind of wadded up.
Sounds terrible. You could get out of it. Hopefully that's what he'll bring in tomorrow. Tippett, you didn't catch a fish today? Did you? Let him go. We're drawing zippers. All right. Well, turn around when we get into it. Now, wait a minute. What's this one moment? You forgot something. Now, here comes a little chicken pair of scissors. We won't count those. Right now, you're still in trouble. You still got about 3 ounces to go. Okay, a little foul. We don't count those. Oh, wait a minute. He's found a pair of glasses he didn't know he had. Well, that may help him. Let's hold everything. Don't touch it. Well, I'm a strong gun. 22-7. How about that? Sound of a gun.
I was hoping I'd have to take a PASS sticker over there.
That's part of the box. Did you know you had it?
Yes, sir. I weighed that on the computer before I left.
How many?
Here comes both. Burning up the wood.
In Salt Lake City.
The sign right there. Keeper.
Our largest bass for the first I know so far is 2 pounds and...
You got a big, what is it, 2 pounds?
What's that in there, 2 pounds? This fish is going to go over 3 pounds. Oh, large mouth and a weight. Look at this beautiful fish. 4 pounds, 12 ounces. Let's give him a great hand. Steve Brown, Steve. Hey, partner, you know what that's going to mean for you if you got the biggest fish today?
Yeah, but we'll wait to see what the other fish and I have to do.
Well, thank you. I don't know. Small. How about a quarter?
That sounds about all I'm going to have.
4 ounces. Save up
the camera.
Film in the camera
far field. Let's get into the good stuff. That's good record stuff. You buy that anyway. Keep the eye on that Zara. That's good. We don't like old good ones. Let's try that one now. That one's pretty one, isn't it? Zara. That's about the last time I walked over there. Look at that. It's got heat. Let's look. Leave it here for a minute.
There he is, for a
reason. What do you see, Harold? Yeah, these balls are baked. They don't weigh anything. Let's get a whole bunch of them.
Throw it in the water, he'll get it. Ellison?
You say get the ball, boy.
Throw it to stick in the water for a dog here.
You competing against a 4 pound and your fish is not quite enough. Two.
No rocks, no bricks.
This is the right point.
All right. Well, we wish you luck, folks. Just give a nice hand and encourage you for tomorrow. It's going to be tough. And that's the key is. Qualified for none of the classics. He's the all time, my dad. So fine to take it. We'll hold the box for you.
Run on screen and get an extra thousand.
4-12. Is that correct, gentlemen? Okay. All right. It's going to go better than 4-12, Roland says, and he's right. This is a spectacular bass.
5-14.
Let's give a nice hand, folks. 5-14. Bob, congratulations. How many did you catch all together? They were keepers.
Hold them up. This way.
That's a boy.
Now you gotta kiss it.
As fast as we do all the bass, and Bob, if you want to, that wasn't exactly what I wanted. How many limits did you catch of keeper bass?
Well, I'd rather not say how many limits I caught.
Okay. You caught a limit or so?
I caught a limit.
Yeah, how many did your partner catch all that? He caught that beautiful bit.
He caught more than that one. He had some more.
In winning the 1976 and 1977 Classic, he was second in the 78 Classic and third in the 1979 Classic. Now we're going to weigh his tackle box. Rick, a few fish here, a few fish there. You get enough, few keepers?
Just a few, Ray. We did a whole lot more running than we did fishing. I really went for a long shot. And I found out that I couldn't, they wouldn't let me in there. But if I could have got in there, it would have been over, I think. But it would take me 3 hours to get through, and 2 hours to get through, 1 hour to get through, 1 hour to get back through.
That's it.
You could get through.
Well, I could get through, but if we calculated the amount of people was in that area. And he mentioned then, he said, you know, if you can get through that lot, he said, it's stumps and trees just like back home. And boy, my, you know, eyes glowed. I'd love to get stumps and trees.
Okay, let's hear Rick Van Dyke's hand. Two times the winner of the Bassmaster Classic. John Hall.
Thank you. Georgia, and with Kevin Fair. Now, for the next man is the all-time money winner, Roy Lyon from Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. 40 years old, his last name, I'm not sure if he's here, but he'll be here tonight, I believe.
What's your share of it?
Okay, I just want to know.
Okay.
And, including, three today to be nervous all the
park up there now.
Larry Dixon, going to the table, from Conroe, Arkansas.
Conway.
And the years.
Conway.
What did I say?
Conroe.
Conway.
That's right there.
Man of the year this year, 30 years old, this is his fourth classic, and the United States is the fifth all-time money winner of Bass Tournament history. Four bass. Four lines. Focus to be a horse race. 14-7. Now remember, four bass alive, and this year we've got one single bass come into feet. They're all in great shape. We make the least confusion to have 100% release.
Wait, good.
I had that Larry Dixon's partner for the day, who spent the entire day looking at Larry's rear end. Back of the boat was Mr. Nelson Brown of the New York Times. Time to announce with H.J. Stevens. Nice hand, folks. H.J. Stevens. We're going to win the big bass, H.J. The weight, 3 pounds, 8 ounces.
2 pounds, 9 ounces. And I might add his partner, Hank Andrews, who has been a classic contender. He's a great rider, friend of ours, a sporting good dealer. Thank you.
The preceding announcement was furnished as a public service by the National Football League. At Atlanta's Fulton County Stadium, this is Don Crickey with John Brody. We're at the half. The Denver Broncos, defending champions of the AFC West against the unbeaten Atlanta Falcons, a team that's won its first two games this year, coming off a playoff season, its first last year. And so far, we've had a lot of offense, 20 points up, 10 for each side.
You know, it's funny because many people said one of the best games that Atlanta played all year last year was their last one against Dallas, even though they lost it. All right, they've come on this year and they've looked like a playoff team. To me, we haven't had a punt in the football game. Now, these are two defensive teams. Neither one of them have punted. I'm looking forward to the second half.
Okay, now let's find out about the rest of the league this Sunday as we go to NFL Control and Bryant Gumbel.
There's a lot of defense being played in the South. Denver and Atlanta, they're all tied at 10. Meanwhile, in Cincinnati, the Bengals trying to come back against New England. That one stands 7-0 at the half. This is week number 3. I'm Bryant Gumbel. Along with Mike Adamly, we will have scores and highlights of this Sunday. We will get to all that action when we come back. But after these messages from your local station.
Opening Monday on Little House on the Prairie, it's Laura's first love.
I'm not a baby anymore. I'm a woman.
Then it's coming home. She was his reason for living, but she was also her husband's reason for coming home. Starring Jane Fonda, John Voight, and Bruce Dern.
NBC, proud as a